This program is rated 16. Parental guidance is advised.
If party after party was a person, it would be me. I'm telling you. I can party on Monday, on Tuesday afternoon, on Monday morning. I don't care. I don't care. First of all, December is upon us. There's a meme that I saw. December is upon us. Please, when you wake up, shower. This December. Gubakumi lesi mnoga mamungenda kunabandi na konabe. Tukumaz. Wona nabi la newestige vizigo watutu sentebe. I'm telling you, this December, when you wake up at 6, at 7, at 8 a.m., hit the shower. First thing, it is party time. Welcome to the show. My name is Mary Luswato. We are at Spectra Salon and Spa. Let me tell you about my natural hair journey. I'm a mother of two. I had a son 1.5 years ago. My hair broke. Ngechwala tachiva kuno. Mpaka kuno. Let me tell you something. It was bad, guys. Nasiba crochet, nensiba crochet, ne mukowa. Because I was trying to hide my chwalata. Look at me now. I am rocking my natural hair. And because I come to this place, they do for me treatments. I don't even know what they mix. I don't want to know. Ne ba mixing ebintu, ne ba biteka in a cup, and they mix for me all these treatments, and my hair is back. My hairline is back. So they are lying to you that breastfeeding will, don't cut off your hair. Before you cut off your hair, I know when you breastfeed, you're going to have your hair fall out. It's hormones, it happens. I can't control it, you can't control it. But guess what? When you nourish it, when you make sure it's very well fed, when there's that protein in there that you can only get from products that we find here, original products, your hair will thrive. So before you cut off as a nakawere, before you go to the salon and they cut off your hair, bring it to Spectra. Wazina Ghana. Bozina gana fefe nyini, tujazi kusalida ko, free of charge. Sit back, relax, get your phone because this is a conversation you want to be a part of. Mwamwe mwagamba no gamba, mbukenzo ya mule mwa, rakubo mwala yaria ya galamba ganga kenzo tazi sobora. Then I said, maybe Rema just wanted a small wedding. Then she proved us all wrong. My God, she put on a show. Like there has not been a... Watch Nyumianzeka, please introduce yourselves.
Yeah, I'm called Neko G.
Neko?
Neko.
Agaliku passport?
Agaliku passport, Neko ya Godfrey.
Neko ya?
Neko lera
Godfrey. Neko lera?
Yeah.
Neko lera Godfrey. Okola mwili? Yes.
Nsiba mvili.
Yeah.
Nsiba mvili. Nsiba dreads by the way. Era.
Olina muyimbi na
ye? Wane Kampala.
Wako sampolinga mwaka imba wano?
Ndi muyimbi, nina kaimba kange baka ite vitavo. Nenga wane Kampala, ndi msiba mvili kama lobo kama zera. Abantu abasinga bamanyi ya kubane bachali wange wano lutuseo bonanga bamanyi abakozi wala
kiche chikwambaza uniform
ekinyambaza uniform nyina kayimba kange bakaita ebitabo kanyambaza uniform kubanga kusawa eno kende mukola chi okupromotinga
Soko kuhide story ye bitabu. Te wabisoma nyo, weju sabukuru, chisi.
No, akaimba ke bitabu na kawandika. Nga nsinzira kumbera eri kufa abantu abana Uganda. Ya, kuba katambula. Nti ndiye nombona abona nyo musome semigo wangu vajia. Chisina zidia chikomando chokanga na soma chi.
Ebitabu.
Nsongezo nga zira ganti. Muna ye, tusomye, ne tusoma. Kuba wala Mary Luswata. Mbutuwa linge yo wansi. Batu buzanga. Chichi chosengo kwa gala.
Okubeira.
Chichi chosomerera. Aba singa tu agambanga. Ingini ya. Dokita. Emi ntunde vyo loya.
Nangi na nidi ya gala kubeira loya.
Pairoti. Kusegera. Nae kusawenu. Wovijukina moro wala
natuwa. Osaka nokuseka.
Kusegera.
Ogamba bilo ya biebishemi.
Batu gamba pairoti. Netusoma. Netusome ranga tuine suri.
Nenga tawali nyonyi ya guwanga.
Kusawenu sina na chikomando chengolashi.
Wakoma mu class.
Nze nakoma mu senior 6. Yeah, ebitabo ne biganirawo ne ngenda ne njibye.
Byagana oba sente za bulamu.
Ah.
Kubanga wano na hosting ko mu John Black na ngamba, nsaina magezi manje nyo.
Anti gaka.
Nabikomya olwa kuba magezi gambula.
Kale ekitufu kiri nti mama wange yatuuka awo nafa mu senior 6. Nafa ni sobola college kweyongerayo kuba yafandi mu senior 5 ne struggling ngane mala senior 6 then ne malira
kati omuntu bwagamba nti agenda kusasulira ogenda ku university ogenda
bangamba kunsasulira
obo mugamba zuko waziteke mu music
walaya atimpa mu music kubanga ero soma no mala tumalirize rango nonyeza akawogo walala
akazendalo ka passing ewo mchalo yo. What should I call you?
My name is Lisham. L-E-S-H-A-M. Lisham Kinogo.
That's what I will find in your passport.
Yes.
On your national ID.
No.
What's your name?
Nanti artist name. Everyone calls me Lisham. You'll not find anyone calling me anything else.
What did your mother name you?
My mother. She named me Lindsay.
Lindsay. So cool.
No, I decided it was too white. So we decided, but anyway, she also gave me the name Lisham, but it's not like officially on my passport or anything. But yeah, that's my name. I'm an actress and a producer.
Actress and producer. Okay, well, I don't mean to probe, but does it pay? Does
what?
Acting. Can you leave off acting in this country?
No, you can't at the moment. Not if you're only getting acting jobs from the country. Mm-hmm. I do not know. Of a single, okay, I know a few actors who live without like a side hustle, but it's not nice. It's like at the moment the industry is still budding, people are not willing to pay for the content, and that's how the money comes. I mean, if I make a movie, people have to pay to watch it. That's the only way I'll get money from the movie, or else, you know, there's not much money in acting, but there's a lot of passion.
Do you get the support you need? Do you feel like the acting industry gets the support they need?
I don't feel like the acting industry gets anywhere near the support it needs. I mean, just from the institutions in place, people definitely need to pay more attention to local cinema because it's growing at a very fast pace. But because there's so much Western cinema out there, we're inclined to look towards that. And because we're looking towards the Western people for kind of like guidance, so we feel like their things are better, their stories are better.
Yeah.
And to be honest, they were also where we were too. I've watched some really bad Western films, which really, were filmed on a good budget. And,
well, I've watched some Nigerian movies now. The production is fantastic. Everything looks good.
Because
but then I've also watched I've watched some Nigerian movies where I'm thinking,
exactly.
Why did they even put this out there?
No, exactly. And that's exactly the market that's here right now. There's so much amazing things out there, but it's not getting as much publicity as it should or as much support as it should. So people see the bad things and just go like, oh, our cinema, oh, what, oh, Uganda. But if people actually went out of their way and actually looked at some of the films that are coming out of Uganda, they'll be surprised.
Yeah.
You know, the camera work, the storyline,
the costuming. I like to tell people that for me, my way of supporting Ugandan film is watching Pearl Magic. I am on that station every day. But I've realized that we watch the same movie 5 times. So you're not providing enough content. The other day I was watching a movie from Zimbabwe.
No, but also that's also on them because we only get as much support as we get. We're not going to walk into and tell them you need to put more Ugandan content up there. That's for them to decide.
But I think they have done their absolute best. It's just that you guys cannot feed the market.
No. That's a very huge misconception. There is so much content. I'm constantly making content. I know people who are constantly making content. So they cannot tell us that we cannot feed the market. They're not willing to pay for it.
Oh.
Our current problem in Uganda is that people are not willing to pay for the content. The content is there. I've worked on productions that are still sitting in like shelves. You know, like series, pilots, so much. There's so much content. So many ideas that we keep pitching to these TV stations and to these content people who are content buyers. But it's that at the moment they're not willing to pay a worthy amount for Ugandan content. That's actually our only problem. Content is there, a lot.
And for me, what frustrates me is that we will have this conversation, but how has the music industry even super, they Baba Iseko, they're beyond you, they're earning, people
and
live
I feel like
off
we need
music.
To work together.
People live off music.
Yes,
and I'm
yes.
thinking your art is even more diverse, more,
yes.
but then I don't know.
I also don't know. Yeah. We're working on it.
Slowly. This is what people don't know about me. My absolute passion, like the thing that keeps me awake in the night, is acting. That's why I got into a TV show where I created a character.
Which TV show is that?
Scoop on Scoop.
Ooh,
I created
yes.
a character And I was that character because I said, if no one is going to cast me,
I'm going to cast myself.
Cast myself. Yeah. I got
That's where we're going.
I got like, a TV show. I cast myself. I just said, Kambayire as this character.
No, that's amazing. Oh, yeah. That's yeah. great. That, that's exactly. what you have to do. You take life.
Exactly.
Take life I by did. Force.
Maybe I should do it again.
Maybe you should. We need more more trailblazers.
Let's pass on the mic. What should I call you?
Call me Richard Flavor.
You look like my friend Angelo Izama.
Who is that?
Never mind.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Richard Flavor.
Yeah. Richard Flavor, what do you do?
The center recorder, the ring recorder set. But kundaga muntu. Call me Richard Sebaduka.
Sebaduka. Sebaduka, what do you do?
Basically, I do artist management and events.
Very nice.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. Do you manage brands that are away from just artists? Brands like mine?
Absolutely. As long as the brand can get out there,
you know,
and make money.
So currently, who are you working with?
Apparently, I work with Kent and Flosso. Oh, you know
Ooh,
them as
my boys. Yes. My Nigeria boys.
Yes.
Yeah.
So, but I've been working with, I've worked with different artists. I've managed different artists in the past,
mm-hmm.
like Ragadi, Coco Finger, Irene Namuru, Fidempa.
Nice.
Yeah. So.
Fidempa, very, very, very talented.
Yeah, but right now he's based in Kenya.
He went back.
He's in Mombasa.
Yeah.
Yeah. Huh, because he has family stuff to handle.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So
before we wrap up this first part of the show, we're going to do our last introduction. Please pass the microphone.
Okay, I'm a lady.
Now, yes, sweetie, work.
Of course, you have to
Yes.
Work for it. Mrs. B,
mm-hmm.
CEO of Spectra Salon and Spa.
Mm-hmm.
I do a lot of things. I'm going to tell you a lot because you know me better than I know myself. So basically, what I do, I'm more into property management. Yeah. This is just my side business where really when I'm out of business, I don't have my cash money to run my corporate life.
Mm-hmm.
You know, corporate is always going to be corporate. It's expensive. So when the corporate life is not there, I'm going to be here.
Mm-hmm.
The CEO Spectra Salon, Mr. B. I'm not going to mention my names because I know you very well.
Yeah. The boss lady, Spectra Salon and Spa. She's always hosting us here. Amazing, amazing soul. You guys, I made a friend in this human being and I've never, ever, ever regretted.
I love you. Can I say something about you?
Mm-hmm.
You're one of the most legit people I've ever met.
Yeah.
And I would say, I got to meet your family,
mm-hmm.
and I'm proud of you.
Ooh! Wow. Guys, you see, before we even get emotional, let's come back.